I'm standing on the bank of the River Lee, which rises in Hertfordshire, runs down here through London, and eventually empties into the River Thames. It's quite a popular place with boaters. You'll see them moving up and down the river all the time, and you'll see hundreds, if not thousands, moored along the river's banks and in the various marinas. It's also quite popular with anglers who come here to catch the fish that live in the waters. There's some quite big species here. We've got carp, bream, pike, and chub. Back in 2013 though, the anglers stopped coming because there were no more fish to catch. In the space of a single day, pretty much all the fish in some stretches of the river were wiped out. There's no single reason for this. The river itself is one of the most polluted in the country. It contains runoff from industrial areas. There's a sewage works up the road which dumps lots of phosphate and E. coli into the water. And thanks to a lot of homes having their bathrooms incorrectly plumbed, it even contains sewage runoff from people's homes. These are harmful in themselves, but they also have the effect of driving levels of dissolved oxygen lower. Add to that a lot of unsightly litter, and you can see that this is not exactly an aquatic paradise. Fish do manage to live here, but only just, and it doesn't take much to push them over the edge. And in 2013, that's exactly what happened. We had a heat wave raising the water temperature, driving oxygen levels even lower, but the final nail in the coffin was the rain. A heavy rainstorm dumped loads of water into the Lee catchment area, which quickly found its way into the river. This sounds like a good thing, doesn't it? A huge influx of fresh, clean rainwater was just what the river needed. The problem is that when rain falls on urban areas, it washes pollutants off the roads and into the river. The pollutants themselves are left there by cars, trucks and vans. It's their exhaust fumes, engine oil, tyre rubber and so on. Normally they're not too much of a problem. They build up a little bit, it rains, they get washed into the river and then they build up a little bit again. In 2013 though, we had several weeks of hot, dry weather followed by a single heavy rainstorm which washed huge amounts of these pollutants down into the water. Already strained to the limit, the river now had lots of oil, zinc, lead and other chemicals to deal with, which was just too much. The fish started to die in their thousands. Apparently the river turned dark grey and there were reports of eels crawling out onto dry land to escape. Eventually the river managed to get restocked. Fish migrated down from the higher reaches of the river down through the locks and weirs. The polluted water itself got washed down into the Thames, and so now everything's back to normal. For the time being. The next time we have a hot, dry spell in summer, followed by a heavy rain shower, it's all going to happen again.